would like to thank our esteemed guests.
So the hints you found in the Kenway House lead to the monument.
What a wonderful use of your time, following me around asking obvious questions.
Well, since Henry isn't here, I thought you might enjoy the company.
I don't require any company, and Mr. Green is following up on some leads of his own.
Oh yes, Mr. Green, that's a fascinating idea. Oh please, Mr. Green, come and take a look at this book and stand oh so close to me, Mr. Green.
I do not. Oh, perhaps you have nothing better to do, but I'm busy protecting the assassins.
Are you really? What was it Father used to say?
Don't allow personal feelings to compromise the mission.
Precisely. Anyway, I'm off. If I find any more wild geese for you to chase, I'll be in touch.
Be ever more pleasant for your absence.
To the Great Fire, in an effort to ensure so great a tragedy will never happen again. I would like to thank our esteemed guests, the Right Honorable Premier Disraeli, members of Parliament and others for being here today.
Looks familiar.
Thank you.
It's in the very top. The key to the vault, and the shroud.
Good day, Miss Frye. I'll take that.
You want shroud to cement your own power. But what if you cannot control it?
And why do you want the shroud? Merely to keep the Templars from having it? How like an assassin. To hold the power of eternal life, and yet be too afraid to use it.
Eternal life? Is that what you think the Shroud offers?
What I think is no longer your concern.
Miss Frye, what a pleasant surprise.
Hello, Clara. I was just going to check on Lambeth since the asylum's closing. What brings you here?
The children in my care have been falling ill. Our usual tonics aren't working. A cane, too.
Are you certain you're feeling all right?
Of course. I am, miss.
Clara! Is there a doctor nearby?
Bring her inside. She simply collapsed?
Yes, she said the others took tonic, but it didn't work.
I should think not. Ever since Elliotson was murdered, the district has been overrun with counterfeit tonics. This one needs proper care. But without the appropriate medication, she and the others will quickly decline.
What do you need?
I need supplies. Plenty of them. And medicine. Some of the less common ingredients are being stolen and sold at auction.
I'd be happy to help.
Here's the list. Miss
Frye. Evie Frye.
I'm Miss Nightingale. How do you do? Please hurry. We don't have much time.
Any goings on?
Come here.
They opened a new pie shop on Fleet Street. Brave move considering what happened in the last one.
You know what to do.
We have work to do.
For you.
I can't thank you enough. These supplies are meant for Miss Nightingale.
I'm here to collect them.
And they're already loaded on the cart. Please take them.
Giddy up!
You mean that cart?
Yes.
Of course it is.
Please be careful. Some of those items are fragile.
Back. And not a moment too soon. I hope you brought the medication I requested.
How is she?
She will recover.
Babylon Alley, the children.
Thanks to you, we can distribute authentic medicine now.
But is that a permanent solution?
I will petition to have regulations put in place.
Lambeth is in your debt.
It takes a long time to change things. But I'm not going anywhere, Miss Frye.
You
Oh, Jacob, Evie, it's you. Thank goodness.
Experimenting, are we, Alec?
Correct.
And looking a bit frazzled.
Nerves. It's those great oafs Static keeps sending round to coax me. He is offering a ridiculous amount of money.
Alec, you're not thinking of jumping ship, are you?
Never. I've been working in something, in case they get too insistent. It's meant to stun an assailant, should the need arise.
Are you certain that it works?
Not as such. I've made three of them with varying degrees of acidity and whatnot. Oh, one must be the right formula.
Let's find some Staric lackeys to target then, shall we?
Speaking of Staric, he is still transmitting false information.
We could simply destroy his transmitters.
His company's too well guarded. The bombs will help, but it would be awkward to produce bombs that potentially do not stun. Oh, wait a minute. Looks like opportunity has come knocking. Oh dear, they never looked so angry before.
Stand clear, Alec.
Let us instead play a little linguistic game with them. Take the bombs and climb onto the roof. When I see the name of a fruit, toss one near the thugs.
Right then.
Oh, wait, I nearly forgot. Slip these into your boots and you will henceforth be immune to all voltaic discharge. I think.
Gentlemen, I would ask you in for tea, but I'm afraid I'm running rather late.
Enough of the niceties. We've come to smash your place up, ain't we, Bess?
You got one of them telly what's it's in here, ain't ya? You've been reading messages from the Staric Company.
That is as untrue as the notion that the Staric Telegraph Company is emitting impartial information, sir.
Come again?
Your employer's promises are nothing but hot air. His operations are about to turn pear-shaped.
Smart Alec's got a sense.
What you going on about air and pears for?
Oh, I don't know, I feel rough.
Oh, that's disgusting. He's trying to be funny.
Oh, you dropped another one, Bill. You little sod.
What? I ain't me, Bez. Oh, God blimey, it's got me through.
Oh, those rascals throwing stink bombs again. It happens all the time around here.
Tell us where you keep that telly, what's it? I'll count to three.
Three? Well, well, let's see how far you get.
One.
Do you really think I would keep it here? Do you see a cable? A telegraph without a cable is about as useful as a bell without a clapper.
I'll give you a bleeding clapper.
Well, bless my boots, you're as purple as a plum.
You are in shock, my dear fellow.
Good show, Alec.
thanks to you, Evie. Your mere presence gave me courage and resolve I never knew I had.
I'm glad I could help. Now it's time to shut down Stark's empire of propaganda.
Got all day.
The longer we can keep Starek from spewing out false information, the more we can awaken the people with the truth about his operations.
I agree. The sooner we can get there, the quicker we can act.
Would you believe my mother says there are still some wives in our street that swear by that shooting star? So I took it upon myself to tell her neighbors the truth about the noxious draft.
That's good, Alec. But you can't go round to every household in London town.
No, I wasn't always welcome. It shows how false information can be as difficult to stamp out as fishwives' profanities at Billingsgate.
Or vermin at Smithfield.
But if we can eradicate a source that continually feeds such detrimental trash, then little by little the truth will take the upper hand and the sham will be flushed out.
That's why we're here.
We'll have to get in without being detected, Mike.
I shall stun them while you get inside.
I shall destroy not one, but three parts of the transmitter. He'll be as good as dancing before a public toilet without a penny.
Mountains. Oh well. Oh, hope the guards don't come patrolling.
I see. This is becoming rather perilous, to say the least. Surely, gosh, help that! Got you, you little bugger.
Cross over here.
I see. This is becoming rather perilous, to say the least.
Back on me.
Oh, golly gosh. Fiddly that one, but I've pulled it as well as a dentist pulls a rotten tooth. There.
Move faster if you can.
I see. This is becoming rather perilous, to say the least. Golly gosh, help them! Golly gosh, help them!
My dears, Jacob, Evie, thanks are once again in order for supporting what is most dear to me, and to our cause, freedom of speech.
It's a blessing that you employ your genius for the common good, Alec.
However, I suggest you vacate your workshop.
No need. Not now. You've given me sacks full of courage. And, besides, What with my little devices, I have all the protection I need. Should you find yourselves with a moment to spare, do drop by.
Miss Attaway.
Yes, may I? Oh. Splendid, you're here to murder me.
I what?
No matter. Everyone has a prize. Is this enough?
I'm not here to kill you.
Then what's your game?
Mr. Starrick and the Milner Company have blocked your ambitions long enough. I have a business proposition for you.
Wonderful. Come with me. We have much to discuss, Mr.
Jacob Frye. At your service.
Truer words were never spoken.
If you'd be so kind as to take the reins. You must understand, I've received threats against my life. Malcolm Milner has all but waged war on me since Mr. Starrick brought out his company. And no offense, I hope, but you do look the king.
I doubt I shall ever recover from such a slight.
What then is your interest in my redemption, Mr. Frye?
I sense an opportunity that will benefit us both.
Do you?
Is that so hard to believe?
Whatever your intentions, it will be quite the tonic to strike back against Milner's. I have... That's one of Milner's. I can't lose another bus! Yeah!
A girl. That's the way.
Malcolm Milner. Starrick's puppet himself.
Careful, you twats! This park scene needs to make it to the Attaway Depot.
He thinks he can burn my buses. Let's give him a taste of his own medicine.
Let's give him the whole damn bottle. We'll turn Milner's park scene against him. But I'll need help from my gang.
Such entrepreneurial instinct, Mr. Frye. I shall leave you to it.
Ha ha ha!
Heave ho, Jacob. Primed and ready.
Plummeting already. You're hired. Oh, I have more business planned for us both. Drop a note to my secretary to make an appointment, and I shall reveal the next step in our scheme.
I don't actually work.
Like that.
Keep moving.
Mr. Frye, I told you to make an appointment.
My schedule was open.
You're fortunate I like you.
Internal combustion engines.
Eight small syllables that mean a great deal of money. The engines will be delivered to Milner by train. Secure them for me, and he will be devastated.
I'll need a second train to pull this off. And I think I know just the man.
So we have a deal, Mr. Frye?
You're fortunate I like you, Miss Attaway.
Don't be afraid to spill a little blood.
Right.
gone,
girl. What's going on out there?
A change of plans. That's what's going on.
Fry? God damn it. Where do you come off rescuing me?
I believe it's pronounced.
So, what do you want, Fry?
What makes you so sure I want something? Perhaps I saved you out of the kindness of my own heart. Come on, let me tell you about the job.
Miller's pulling a lot of cargo there.
Just be sure to make the transfer.
Give him hell.
Get a move on, Fry!
Internal combustion engine. The end of horse-drawn transport. It's like gazing into the future.
What is the going rate for the future, do you think?
We're not selling them.
You're giving them to your contact?
You'd be paid all the same.
Who is this Pearl, anyway? How long have you been working with her?
She's a business partner. That's all you need to know.
Thank you.
James, I hope I didn't make it too la-di-da. Slap some gold leaf here and there. I gave the wood a splash of shellac. Upholstered the lot. And how do you like the lampshades?
The city districts appear to finally be in some sort of...
Miss Frye, I brought some books. I hope I'm not intruding by being here.
Quite the contrary. It's nice to have the company. A herbarium? Are you collecting flowers for someone?
Only myself. I'm told it's something of a British pastime. Did you know, they all have symbolic meanings?
I had heard something of the sort.
Of course you have. Unfortunately, I have no time to fill the book.
I could collect some samples, if you would accept my help.
I would appreciate that. Thank you, Miss Frye.
have a job? Charge him. Wreak some havoc.
Jacob, darling, do join me.
To our fruitful partnership.
And to the shiny new engines now in my possession. Back to business. Milner's fled to the Thames, occupied with securing his ferry. It's all he has left.
Protecting it with his life, no doubt.
The very thing I want you to take. Just kill him.
That's not your first glass of champagne, is it?
Success is more intoxicating than alcohol, Mr. Frye.
Then save a glass for me.
Now, what would it take to draw Staric's pawn? The sight of his ferries in flames, perhaps. Now to sink Milner's enterprise. Thank you.
I lost the engines. So this is my comeuppance.
Pearl Attaway led me to you, not Starrick.
Then they were gonna give her again. I should never have come between Mr. Starrick and Miss Attaway. Family always stay together in the end.
What do you mean, their family?
Time for Pearl and I to have a real conversation.